Sunday, the 10th of July, 1977. In England, it is bedtime, but here in Vancouver, it is about 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Today, Vancouver is large and prosperous. It's a bit difficult to imagine that only a century ago, it was a small and isolated town with seemingly poor prospects. Of course, the future of the whole of Canada was in the balance at that time, mainly owing to its vast size and the lack of communications. Someone wrote in a newspaper, "We Canadians don't know each other, we have no trade with each other. We have no facilities or resources or incentives to mingle with each other. We are shut off from each other by a wilderness, geographically, commercially, politically and socially. We always cross into the United States to shake hands." In 1871, they joined the Confederation, which had come into existence 4 years earlier. But it was not until 1885 that the first railway reached Vancouver. After that event, of course, things began to change and develop rapidly. Today, Vancouver has a cosmopolitan population of well over 1 million. It has a university, a planetarium, several skyscrapers, a parking problem, Chinese restaurants, Japanese restaurants, nightclubs, streetwalkers, plenty of high life, plenty of low life. In a word, everything you'd expect to find in a modern Western city.